Today's episode with Bradley Pinion, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers Super Bowl championship punter, is presented by Convoy of Hope. And we're going to talk about Convoy Nation and the great work they're doing fighting hunger, poverty, and suffering in the United States and throughout the world. It's all coming up right now on Sports Spectrum.
This is Sports Spectrum, the intersection of sports and faith, where we bring Jesus back into the conversation. Here's your host, Jason Romano.
What's up, guys? Welcome to the show. I am Jason, and this is the Sports Spectrum podcast. So glad you're tuning into the show today. Make sure you check out our website, sportsspectrum.com. That's our home base for all of our content. That's a great place to bookmark and go back to every single day with updated content, updated articles, devotionals, podcasts, all available at sportsspectrum.com, the intersection of sports and faith. We got a great conversation today with Bradley Pinion. He is the Tampa Bay Buccaneers punter and a Super Bowl champion. Now, we've had Bradley on a couple of times previously. Right before the Super Bowl, actually, we talked to him about getting ready for the big game. And then we had him on a little bit over a year ago or so, maybe 2 years ago, telling his Jesus story. And man, an amazing story of what led to eventually him choosing Clemson to play his college football and then coming into the NFL and leaving early from Clemson and betting on himself. And it's worked out. And God has guided him all the way to the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and now to a Super Bowl championship. Bradley is also involved with an amazing ministry called Convoy of Hope, our partners and sponsors on today's podcast. ConvoyNation.com is the website to go check out. We'll be saying that quite a bit on today's interview. So we talked to Bradley about his Super Bowl victory, about what it's like to be a Super Bowl champion, some of the cool experiences that he had after winning the big game, and then his involvement with Convoy of Hope and why he got involved, why the Lord was tugging at his heart to say yes to jumping all in with Convoy of Hope. This is Bradley Pinion from the Tampa Bay Buccaneers Super Bowl champion joining us here today on Sports Spectrum. Super Bowl champion punter, Bradley Pinion. What's up, buddy?
How's it going, man? You know, the Super Bowl champion has a nice ring to it.
It has a nice ring to it, right? That's never going to get old, is it?
No, it hasn't gotten old yet, but it still doesn't feel real yet either.
I can imagine. It's been, well, I guess we're at almost 3 months since you all won the Super Bowl, 31-9. It's crazy. 3 months flies by. You do it in your home stadium. You beat the Chiefs. So in many ways, it was an upset. What, if anything, Brad, has changed for you other than people like me calling you a Super Bowl champion?
Really not too much. Life got crazy for a little bit, like right after the Super Bowl. Just kind of everybody wanting to see you, everybody wanting to congratulate you, everybody wanting to really just love on you and really just give you high praises. And that was a little crazy at first, but then everything's kind of died down. It's back to normal life with my wife and our four dogs, and we're just chilling on the lake in South Carolina and kind of soaking it all in and getting ready for next season.
When you picked up your phone after you walked into the locker room at whatever point that was after winning the Super Bowl, how many messages were on your phone?
I think at one point I looked and it was like 130 something. And then they just kept rolling in and I was trying to get to all of them. And if I haven't gotten to anybody, I'm sorry, but that was a completely absurd moment. And I tried to reply to everybody, but I highly doubt I got everybody.
Well, hopefully people had some grace. I mean, you have to have grace in a moment like that when you're realizing if you're texting a player who just won the Super Bowl, unless your mom or dad or brother or wife or girlfriend, you might fall into that second tier of people that, you know, it'll take a while to get back to you.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I had a bunch of my friends and family down here, which was amazing to be able to celebrate with them. It was something else. So all the text messages and phone calls and social media, it was, you could feel the love for sure.
You haven't gotten your ring yet, obviously, but did you keep anything from the game? Like, do you guys get to have your jersey and keep all the different, I don't know, even a football, anything like that?
Yeah, I kept a lot of stuff from the game, actually. Cleats, jerseys, I mean, confetti. I kept a lot of, I probably kept too much stuff, honestly, from the Super Bowl. I have bunch of stuff. The really cool part was the confetti had little like tweets on it that like players had tweeted about the Bucks or about the Chiefs. I think it was all about the Bucks because they had our confetti, but like one of the pieces of confetti I have is Tom Brady's tweet and just has a W. So it's kind of cool.
That is pretty cool. I mean, how they even thought about doing that is crazy. What else is, like, what's the coolest thing that you got to experience because you won a Super Bowl? A lot of times that opens up doors, or even post-game parties I know that take place. And I know we're in the middle of COVID still, but you guys were still able to have some fun, I'm sure. What's the coolest thing that's taken place since you won the Super Bowl for you?
You know, I got to be honest, this is going to sound cliche, but our parade was epic.
Okay.
It was one of those, just like no other team has ever had a boat parade, like being on the boat with all your buddies and your family. Man, it was awesome. I don't know if I'll ever be able to experience something like that again. Hopefully we can experience something like that again this year. But no, it was really cool. That boat parade was unreal. And then I would say the moment that it kind of hit me, that we had kind of like, oh my God, we just won the Super Bowl, was when my wife came on the field. And I was fine until then, but as soon as I embraced my wife, the tears just started flowing. And it was one of those things where I was like, man, like, this is real. And she kept saying, like, oh my God, you did it. We did it. Like, we won the Super Bowl. And I'm like, yeah, we did. Like, it was a surreal moment.
It's like the culmination of, you know, so much hard work for you too, probably, right? Thinking back to all those balls that you kick in the off season and all the years that you put in, and having that moment, it's probably all of that kind of coming to a boiling point right at that moment.
Absolutely. No, it was all those years of hard work. I was really fortunate to be able to have my longtime kicking coach on the field with my wife. And so it was a really cool moment for all of us.
What was, from a spiritual perspective, that like leading up to the Super Bowl? Were you able to still do Bible study and prayer time and chapel or anything like that leading up? Or was it kind of a crazy week and you weren't able to keep
it
the rhythm?
Really we kind of just treated it like another week. The whole organization did. I mean, it was a big game, of course, but we really treated it just like another week, like another game. We had our normal Bible study, our normal team chapel. It was kind of cool because we had Tony Evans do the chapel, so that was kind of special. But
yeah,
it was like just honestly a normal week. And I honestly think that's one of the reasons why we won, is because we didn't treat it like any other game than just a normal game. Because that's what it was. It was just a game of football. It might be the biggest stage, but it was just another game of football.
Yeah.
And in the grand scheme of things, when it's all said and done, honestly, some fans might hate me saying this, it doesn't matter if you win or lose that game anyway, because the good Lord Jesus is your savior, and he doesn't care if you win or lose as long as you glorify him. So with that kind of freedom and that, when you're able to just kind of play freely like that, it's huge.
Yeah, that's good. And it also allows you, though, a platform to be able to point people to Christ, which is pretty cool. Now that you have that Super Bowl title to it, you're able to point people to it. One of the things that you're involved with, Bradley Pinion, who's our guest here on Sports Spectrum, Super Bowl champion, Tampa Bay Buccaneers punter, is Convoy of Hope. And we love what Convoy of Hope is about. They're one of our newest partners with us here on Sports Spectrum. I want to talk about your connection with Convoy Hope and Convoy of Hope and Convoy Nation. Let's just start with how you were able to even connect with Convoy of Hope and even get involved with them.
Yeah, so back in my rookie year in San Francisco, I had the pleasure of going to eat dinner before a game with this guy's named Kirk and Hal. And they're the two of the founders, or Hal's the founder, and Kirk is really involved in Convoy of Hope. And I had the pleasure of going to eat with them. And we just hit it off. I hit it off with the people that they are, the good, genuine people that they are. They never even pushed Convoy down my throat or anything along those lines. It was very much like, let's just go take these people, love on them, love on these guys, and just have a good time. That's what they did. And then I ended up staying in contact with Kirk, who runs Convoy Nation. And it's just been more so started off as a friendship. And I just saw how good of people that they were and that they are. And it's kind of blossomed into this awesome partnership of being able to do this amazing work that Convoy does. I mean, they help people all across the world, honestly, not just here in the United States, but all over the world. They have programs called Feed One, where you can donate monthly to feed children. I believe they feed over like 300,000 kids every school day all across the world. They do disaster relief. They have women empowerment, agricultural education, where they go into these impoverished countries, impoverished towns and villages, and they don't just feed them, they teach them how to grow food and how to be sustainable themselves. So, like the Bible says, teach a man to fish, and you feed him for a lifetime, not just give a man a fish. So it's one of those things where they do all this amazing faith-based work, and it's honestly a joy to be a part of it.
So you get asked to do a lot of things, I'm sure, being an NFL player. Why Convoy of Hope? Like, why say yes to them? What was it that really tugged on your heart? Was there a moment? Was there something that was said by Kirk or some of the other guys? Was it a video you saw? Was it just the right timing? You know, God's timing is perfect. What was it that kind of just forced you to, you know, or convinced you to say yes to this?
I don't even know if I ever really said yes, to be honest with you. It was just one of those things where it just felt natural. It felt like, you know what, like, I want to make a difference. These people want to make a difference. And we can help each other make a difference. And that was the biggest thing. It was never, like I said, pushed down my throat or never anything. It was more sort of like a friendship that has blossomed into this partnership, like I said, where it's been like, hey, like, I want to do this event. I want to feed a bunch of kids in Tampa, or I want to feed a bunch of kids in South Carolina, and I want to give them shoes. I want to do all this stuff. And Convoy has those resources to help with that. And it's been, like I said, an awesome partnership. Awesome friendship, more so than a partnership, of just really actually, you know what, I think what drew me to Convoy was the people. Hal, the founder of Convoy, is probably one of the most genuine, godly people you ever meet. And I think he just has a heart of gold. And Kirk is the same way. I think they're both very, very good people, very giving and faith-based people. And I think that's the main reason I'm involved. When you have people at the top that are faith-based, it's kind of hard not to enjoy life.
Your faith guides you in everything you do, right? And you said the dreaded words, like, it wouldn't have mattered if you won or lost. Obviously, you always want to win the Super Bowl, but God's still the same yesterday, today, and forever, right? Jesus is the same. How does that kind of come into play into your involvement with Convoy? Clearly, it's a big part, your faith.
Yeah, it's a huge part. They're a faith-based organization, but they're not the faith-based organizations that's going to like slam it in your face all the time. And I might be going off topic here, but that's kind of the way some Christians have gone nowadays. I mean, they want to slam it all in your face and tell you what you're doing wrong, and that's not what Christ tells us to do. He tells us to love and show his love, and that's how you draw people to Christ. And that, I mean, I'm a firm believer in that, and I'm a firm believer in that's what they do. I mean, they partner with some schools that aren't Christian-based, and the reason they can do that is the schools will be like, hey, like, you're Christian-based. I don't know if we can do this. And he was like, well, do you feel like we're pushing it in your face right now? And they're like, always no. And I was like, well, that's exactly how we're going to be when we do this event. We're not trying to push faith in your face. We're trying to serve because God has called us to serve. And that's what our faith believes. And that we believe we are ministering to you through serving. We don't have to say a word. God will do the rest. And I think that's awesome. I think that's huge. I mean, that's, like I said, it's what Christ has called us to do, is to serve and to love others. That's exactly what Convoy does.
Yeah. And I've heard the line, even as parents, more is caught than taught, right? And we always want to teach, and we never want to not tell people about Jesus, but I think they're not going to care how much you know until they know how much you care, right?
Right. Exactly. I mean, nobybody's going to listen to you when you just come up to them and be like, hey, you need to know Jesus. Like, that's just not how people operate. When you show them that, hey, that Jesus is love, Jesus is kindness, and they see those things in you, then they're going to be like, hey, tell me about like why you are the way you are. And then that's the perfect opportunity to key up the Jesus song.
That's cool. Bradley Pinion's joining us here on Sports Spectrum. It's Convoy of Hope that he's associated with. ConvoyNation.com is the website, ConvoyNation.com. Tell us exactly what you've done with Convoy. You know, you kind of alluded to it, but what's an example of a way, like if somebody else is listening, right, and they want to get involved, and they're like, I'm not sure what Convoy of Hope, how we can work with them to work with our ministry or our area, whether they're faith-based or not. What is it exactly that you've done to partner with them that maybe people are hearing as an example that they can implement into their own situation?
Yeah, so we've done a few things. One of the main things we've done is disaster relief. When I was in California playing for San Fran, they had the wildfires, and we always helped with donations and make these places had relief through Convoy. So we did some of that. We've also, San Fran did a massive event every year where they would feed and give clothing and books and family photos and just a really awesome, it's called a pro series event, that's what they call them. And we did that in San Fran for 3 years. And like I said, you'd feed like 2,000 people and give 2,000 shoes and like haircuts. I mean, it's one of those events that it's just like, you don't realize what your impact that you're doing until you slide a shoe on a kid's foot and you see them light up and you light up at the same time. And it's just surreal. So it's another thing we're doing. We're actually working on right now, doing one in South Carolina and one in Tampa. It's called the Pro Series event, and we take volunteers for those. So if you're ever interested in volunteering, hit me up, hit Convoy up, and they'll definitely hook you up with that. And then we also do the Feed One. You can donate monthly to do this Feed One. And I don't know if we're donating right now or not, honestly, but we've donated in the past to do Feed One, where it feeds children all across the world. Like I said earlier, they feed over 300,000 kids a day, every school day. So those are definitely ways, really easy ways to get involved. There's also more ways to get involved with the women empowerment and the agricultural education. And I mean, I know I'm missing, I think they have like 7 pillars, and I know I'm missing some of them, but there's so many ways to get involved. You can go to their website and find out all those ways to get involved. And they're just a great organization. I'm telling you, you won't regret it. The day of the Super Bowl, day after the Super Bowl, or before the Super Bowl, they had an event in Tampa, and my wife went out and was handing shoes at a drive-through event, shoes and socks. So I'm telling you, they're doing it everywhere, all over the place, all the time. So.
It's interesting, too, to think, wait, you're handing out shoes and socks. Doesn't everybody have shoes and socks? And you realize there are a lot of families living on the fringe and have fallen into that depths of poverty and suffering. What's it do to you when you go and you see someone in need and then know that, you know, being the hands and feet of Jesus, as we talk about a lot, to be able to give them something as simple as shoes and socks and see them light up? What's that do for you?
Oh, man, it's huge. I always say every time after you get done with these events, I think I get more out of it than they do. Because seeing the joy that Jesus can bring, I think that's the biggest thing. When you're serving someone, and when you're basically, I won't say putting yourself below them, but when you're trying to be a servant, you're not trying to lead. Because in the position that we're in, a lot of times you get lifted up. And when you're trying to really humble yourself, and when you're trying to do the godly things, I mean, the reward that you feel from Jesus and that happiness, when you're doing God's words, it's kind of unexplainable. And then when you see the joy on these families' faces, or these kids that haven't had a haircut maybe in I don't know how long, or they haven't had, like you said, I've had shoes. When you think kind of to us, like shoes is just like, oh, you're going to have shoes. Like when they haven't had a new pair of shoes in 2 years and their shoes are 3 sizes too small and you give them the right size shoe, like the joy on their face is unreal. Or these people that have never had family photos taken and they get a family photo.
Yeah.
Or you send them away with like a month's worth or a few weeks worth of groceries, like, and they're usually worried about where their food's going to come from. Like you start seeing like a change in yourself when you start seeing the happiness of these people. One of my favorite stories, and I'm not gonna put this person on blast, but we had this event in San Fran, and this guy was a higher up in a company, and he had never really like been on the front lines and served. He'd always donated his time, his money. And so he got on the front line and served and was doing this event in San Fran, and he was actually out there handing out groceries. And he was just handing out groceries. And at the end of the event, you walked up to him, and he was just like crying. He was just bawling his eyes out. I'm like, dude, like, are you okay? Like, what's wrong? He was like, you know, I've always given all this money, but I've never actually been on the front lines and got to touch the people's hand that I'm giving to and I'm giving for. And he's like, it's just a totally different feeling, a totally different reward. He was like, this is what I've been missing. Like, this is what Jesus is about. That's one of the best, like, I guess that's the best compliment you can ever give Convoy. When you give people the opportunity to see what Jesus is about in a giving and nurturing manner, I mean, come on, you can't beat that.
Absolutely. He is Bradley Pinion. Again, Convoy of Hope is the wonderful organization, and the work that they're doing is so important. It's convoynation.com is the website to learn more. You can donate there too, but I think, like you said, maybe there's a way to set up to get involved, volunteer, and even set up an opportunity to have Convoy of Hope come and partner with you to feed, to provide haircuts and hygiene solutions and clothing and all of these awesome and things that I think we do take for granted. But you can check it out at convoynation.com to be a part of Convoy of Hope. All right, last question, Bradley. This is going to be the question that I've asked you probably the last 2 times you were on the show, and I ask almost everyone, but I'm fascinated, even let's just say the last 3 months, where you've been a Super Bowl champ and, you know, the top of the heap, if you will, in terms of winning it all. What's the great lesson now that God is teaching you and showing you, maybe even just since you've, you know, won the Super Bowl? What's the lesson he's teaching you right now?
I would say the biggest one I'm learning right now is to find peace in the craziness, to always take a step back and just realize, like, man, God has gotten you this far. He's going to take you even farther. He's always got your back, and just kind of find that peace. And when everything crazy is going on, my wife has done a wonderful job of that for me recently, with all the craziness, and I'm trying to please all these people and get pulled all these different directions. She's really always pushed to be like, hey, like, you just need time to be you. You need time to relax. You need time to just reflect on everything that's happened. And that's the biggest thing. Always take that time to reflect. Because if you don't reflect, you really can't move forward in my eyes. Because if you don't see what God has done in your life, you're not really going to have that purpose to keep living to see what else God is going to do. So I think that's my biggest thing right now. It's taking that time to reflect, relax a little, and just be like, man, like, Jesus has blessed us. God has blessed us more than we can even imagine. And realize that, and then thank him for that, and then look forward to the many more blessings to come. I'm not saying that bad things won't happen or anything along those lines, because they're going to. Yeah. But just seeing Jesus in all of it and finding God in all of it, I think that's the biggest takeaway I've had recently.
That's good. He is Bradley Pinion, Tampa Bay Buccaneers Super Bowl champion punter. Involvement with Convoy of Hope. Again, convoynation.com is the website to learn more. And we appreciate you, my friend. Thanks for doing this. And we'll have to get you back on again, hopefully after another Super Bowl. Who the heck knows? But you got your whole squad back, it looks like. So you're gonna make another run for it.
Trying to. Got all 25 of us. There's been all these reports about 22. It's 25 getting the specialist. So all 25.
I don't forget the specialists.
I know. 25 of us are back, and we're excited to make another run at this thing. And working harder than ever, more hungry than ever. And I think we got something special building in Tampa.
Love it. It's great, man. Thanks for joining us. We'll talk to you soon.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Many thanks to Bradley Pinion from the Tampa Bay Buccaneers for joining us here today on the show and being a part of a great ministry, Convoy of Hope. You can learn more about Convoy of Hope by going to convoynation.com, convoynation.com. In doing so, you'll hear all about what Convoy of Hope is about and advocate with them. You can partner with them, donate, maybe even have them come and be a part of something that you have going on, or you can go volunteer with them to give and network and help ensure that those in need receive hot meals and groceries and haircuts and dental screenings and family portraits, hygiene kits, and much, much more. Check them out at convoynation.com. And again, thanks to Bradley Pinion for being here on Sports Spectrum today, Super Bowl champion. Man, that's got to be cool, right? I mean, imagine you're a punter in the NFL and you go and you get this opportunity to play on the highest level and you get to win a Super Bowl in your home stadium. And now you get to walk around in the offseason. And obviously, you got to work hard and stay prepared and go after it again next year. But you're a Super Bowl champ. That's just so cool. And I'm glad Bradley was able to share it here on Sports Spectrum. We're glad that you tuned in as well. Thank you for joining us. Make sure you subscribe, rate, review, and share this podcast with someone that you think would be encouraged by hearing this. And in a way, you're kind of serving as an ambassador for Sports Spectrum, but you're also serving as an ambassador for Christ by sharing an interview like today's with someone that you know would be interested. Maybe they love sports. Maybe they're a follower of Christ that loves football. This was the podcast to share. So hopefully you'll do that. We appreciate you so much. We love you guys. Tune in next time for another episode of Sports Spectrum. See you then.